I was a successful illustrator and my art career was at an all-time high and I was living my dream of being an artist and I didn't see a need for God in my life. And then one day I met a girl who wanted me to go to church with her. I suddenly was hit on the side of the head by God, who opened my eyes to the fact that being an artist wasn't all something that I had done on my own, but that he had given me a gift. That very day, I gave my life to Christ. I said to him, please use me. And the very next day, supernaturally, no other way to say it, I got a phone call from Focus on the Family. It was something I could never imagine, that God would work so quickly from a prayer I had prayed the day before. And I did a series for them on a McGee and Me series, and then many, many other projects. So I've been working with an art director at Focus on the Family, and I was working on Breakaway magazine for him, and he wanted me to come out to the Pomona office. That was where he also offered me a lot of these tapes that were from the broadcast. I started listening to those tapes while I would paint. And it was really something that formed my very first early understanding of the character of God. And the ministry helped feed my Christian life, learning and listening to the broadcasts. And back then, Dr. James Dobson's books were something that my wife and I, early on, even before we got married, we were interested in reading about, or you know, marriage. And also, as we got our first child, The Strong-Willed Child, and all the books that were at our disposal all were like constantly being read by us to try and figure out how to be a good parent. So to this day, we still are amazed at how much we have, you know, learned from Focus on the Family. I'm thrilled to death, you know, to be able to have this whole come full circle where I became a Christian the day before Focus on the Family called me, and now I get to, you know, have my art be something that helps Focus on the Family. This painting is something that's been in the back of my mind, not knowing when or who or what would make it happen. So I'm so grateful that I just waited on the Lord to know when to do this painting. And it's more than just a painting of some kids with candles, but that there's a deeper meaning that went into the painting of it that was in my heart. And I hope some of that comes across to the people who see it, you know, that want to put it on their wall and be reminded daily of what Christ has done for them and how they want to share that good news with other people. And then, you know, maybe you'd like to actually live with it.